हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द 8th लेक्चर ऑफ द थियोलाइट सर्वेइंग दैट इज़ ऑन द बैलेंसिंग ऑफ ट्रैवर्स, राइट? सो नॉट मच मोर, बट वी विल जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज़ बैलेंसिंग ऑफ ट्रैवर्स, ओके, एंड व्हाट आर इट्स टाइप्स. आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन वन ऑफ इट्स टाइप टुडे, ओके. सो टुडे इन द कंटेंट और टुडेज लेक्चर विल बी हैविंग बैलेंसिंग द ट्रैवर्स बाय बाउडीज रूल, right? And a problem. Problems will be taking in the next class because the problem is a little bit bigger, but it continues in the same lecture itself. Okay. So what is the balancing of traverse? We'll first understand. The balancing of traverse is nothing but a process of applying corrections to the latitude and departure so as to make the algebraic sum of latitude and departure are equal to zero is known as balancing of traverse. Now in the previous lecture we have studied about the closing error, right? We have studied about the closing error. If when you are drawing a when you are computing a traverse or when you are making a traverse on the ground, right, if they at the last they connect at the both here, right? If traverse connects each other properly like this, then it is a closed traverse. Then your summation of latitude and summation of departure will be equal to zero and there will be no closing errors, right? And if there is an closing error. What is closing error? You are not able to close this traverse like this. There is a gap. The distance between the distance which has been computed is not able to be measured here. Okay, so there is a gap between and the first point and the last point are not meeting at a same point, right? And they are not meeting. So what happens? There is an closing error. There is a while closing, there is an error. So to overcome this closing error, once the closing error has happened, how to get the proper result, right? We want to recorrect it. We have to correct it now. So to correct it, we have to use the method called balancing of traverse. You are going to balance the all these sides and latitude and departures, right? So that we will have a closed traverse. Right? The process is applied only for the closed traverse. It is applied for only closed traverse only. Right? These are the following methods which are used for calculation or for the balancing of traverse. The first one is the Bowditch rule. Right? Second is transit rule. Right? And the third one is graphical method, right? From in this, you are going to use today in the Bowditch rule, second is transit rule, and third is graphical method. So in this lecture, you are going to study about the Bowditch rule. What is Bowditch rules and what are its formulas that you are going to use? And you'll be studying the problem. We are going to do the problem in the coming lectures, right? So Bowditch rule is also known as compass rule. Okay, it is also known as compass rule, right? It is also known as compass rule, and is generally used to adjusting the traverse in which angles and distance are measured with equal precisions. So why there are types? Depending upon the precision of the work, on what dimensions you have measured with precisely. Okay, if you have measured the distance and the angles with very precise way, then you are going to use Bowditch rules. This might be asked in your MCQs for your assignments or quiz, right? Or this might be asked in some of the exams. Okay, sometimes this might be asked, why is explain the types of balancing of traverses and why, which give the reason which you are going to use, why you are going to use. So for that you can tell them that Bowditch rule is used, is also known as compass rule, and it is used only when the angle and the distance measured, right, the distance measure of the traverse is very precise, then only you are going to use the Bowditch rule. In this rule, total error in the latitude and departure is distributed in the proportion to the length of its sides. Now, what we are going to do is, we are going to, whatever the error that has happened, right? If there is error of 2 meters, right? Then if there are 4 or 5 sides of a traverse, then we are going to divide that error into, add those errors into the 5 sides, okay? And we have to make up it, we have to balance it, right? That is how we are going to do it. Okay, here we are going to whatever the error is there, that is going to be distributed, okay, as a correction is done, and it is distributed to each and every line or sides, each and every latitude and departure, not only to the last one. If I say this is your, if this is your traverse and it is not closing here, right, this is not closing here, so we are not going only going to correct this line, okay, we are going to correct the whole traverse by little bit of adding, okay, little bit of correcting each and every line on the traverse. It is not that only last line will be, which is not closing, will be corrected. All the lines in the traverse will be corrected, okay, will be adjusted, you can say like that, right? Formula for this is correction for latitude for any line, okay, both latitude and departure, that also what I was saying, we are going to correct it on the basis of proportionality. We are not going to corrected with only one side or one basis, we are going to proportionate with the both the bases, that is latitude, departure, length, okay, so that is what we are going to do. So the formula is so the correction for latitude on any line is equal to total error in latitude into the length of that line upon traverse, perimeter of traverse. So just understand and under this formula now, for now itself, when we will start solving the problems, we will understand what is total error in the latitude, length of that line, okay, and the perimeter of the traverse. These three things are easy, two things are easy, that is length of the line means the length of that line, okay, and the perimeter of traverse means total length of the perimeter, total length of the traverse, okay. Same for departure, but one thing changes is total error in latitude, and here in the departure it becomes total error in departure, okay. Yeah, so this is for today. We'll be completing today's lecture here itself, and we'll be in the next class, we'll be trying to understand transit rule, okay.